Hello everyone, myself Sangeeta Sharma from Ved Aradhna English Medium School. Hope you all are healthy and safe at your home. Today we will do revision of NCERT EBS textbook class 4th, which reads as chapter 7 from the window, chapter 8 Reaching Grandmother's House and chapter 9 Changing Families. So let's start. Chapter 7. Chapter 7 From the Window. It is morning now. Last night I went to sleep early. It was too dark to see anything outside. When the train stopped early this morning, I woke up. It was Madgaon railway station. That was written on the board at the platform. Appa said that we were going through the state of Goa. We got off at the station and had some hot tea and filled our water bottles. The train started again. I find it difficult to describe the scene outside. It is so beautiful. It is green everywhere. Fields with red soil, green crops, and hills covered with trees. Sometimes I can see small ponds and far away behind the hills, more water. I can't make out if it is a river or sea. Omana confused. The air is cooler and not so dry as in Ahmedabad. The train passed a level crossing. People are waiting on both the sides of the crossing for the train to pass. There are buses full of people, cars, trucks, auto rickshaws, cycles, motorcycles, scooters, and even tongas and bullock carts with people and goods in them. Some people do not switch off the engines of their vehicles. Even while waiting, there is a lot of smoke and noise. I see some people going under the bars of the level crossing. How dangerous this is, Omana thought. At times, our train crosses another train. Annie and I try to count the carriages in one such train, but both the trains were going so fast. We always got confused. Here are some questions we will solve after completing this chapter. Now, heading off, discuss. Sometimes people cross the tracks even when the crossing is closed. What do you feel about this? Now, later, I was sitting near the window with my eyes closed. Suddenly, the sound of the moving train changed. Khur, khur, khur. I opened my eyes. Guess what I saw? Our train was crossing a very big river on a very long bridge. As it was crossing the bridge, it sounded very different. The wheels rattled as there was no ground, only the tracks and the water down below. When I first looked down, I felt greedy. It was really quite scary. The river down below was full of water and had some boats. I could also see some fishermen on the banks. I waved at them, but I did not know if they could see me. Alongside our bridge, there was another bridge for buses and cars. This was built differently from ours. I think going over our bridge was more adventurous. Here are some questions. Have you seen any bridges? You have to write yes or no. The last few hours have been so exciting. After breakfast, I climbed onto the upper berth to read my comics. It was bright and sunny outside. Suddenly, everything became dark. It also felt a little cold inside. I was afraid. Then the light in the train came on, but outside it was very dark. Somebody said, "We have entered a tunnel. This goes right through the mountain." The tunnel seemed to go on, and then just as suddenly we were in daylight again. Outside it was sunny, bright and green. The train had crossed the tunnel. Appa means father. Appa explained that we were on the other side of the mountain. Since then, we have passed through four smaller tunnels. Now, I am enjoying going through the tunnels. Here are some questions we will solve after completed this chapter. Now, it is afternoon. For lunch, we had idli vada that we bought from Udupi railway station. We also bought some bananas also. These were very small and very tasty. Banana was very small and tasty. The scene outside has changed again. Now we can see many coconut trees and green fields everywhere. Amma means mother. Amma says that these are paddy fields. The houses and villages look very different. People's clothes are also different from what we see. In Ahmedabad, most people are wearing white or cream colored dhotis and saris. Many people who were with us from Ahmedabad have got off. People have also got on to the train from different stations. Sunil's family is getting off at Kozhikode. Sunil was Omana's friend, which comes at around 6 o'clock. We have exchanged addresses and plan to meet in Ahmedabad. You will also like Sunil and Anne. Again, here are some questions. Now, it is night. We have also started packing up. The train will reach Kottayam in about 3 hours. That is where we have to get off. Kottayam is a place. Tonight, we will go to Valiamma's house. Valiamma means grandmother. Tomorrow, we will take the bus that will take us to Amumma's village. Amumma means also grandmother. We all are quite tired. After all, we have been on the train for 2 days. What a long journey it has been. We had a lot of fun. I will put my diary away now. I will write again after we reach Amumma's house. Here are some questions. Now, we will read chapter 8, Reaching Grandmother's House. 17th May night. After our long train journey, we reached Kottayam in the night. Valiamma's house was not far from the station and we had to take 2 auto rickshaws to get there. By then, I was very sleepy and did not even wait to eat anything. I took a bath and slept. I thought I had just fallen asleep when Amma woke me up again. We got ready, took our luggage and went to the bus stand. Valiamma's family also came with us. Omana said, we were 10 people and had a lot of luggage too. The bus conductor came and Appa bought tickets for all of us. We managed to get seats as it went along. The bus got very crowded. People were sharing the seats. We also had to share our seats. After a long ride, the bus reached the last stop. I was happy to get off. My legs were stiff. I could hardly stand. I thought that we had finally reached Amma's village, Omana thought. But no, our travel had not ended yet. The bus had dropped us by the waterside. Look, Amma pointed across the water. That is where we have to go. But how will we get there? I wondered. Just then, I saw a boat coming. There is the ferry. Ferry means boat. Amma said, immediately, a big crowd of people started getting off. School children, men, women, all with their own packets and luggage. Amma explained that the ferry was used by reach the other side. As soon as the ferry got, here each ferry means boat, the ferry got empty, the big rush started from our side. Everyone had to pay the fare before getting on. Very soon the ferry was full. It started off again. I managed to get a place to stand along the railing. I saw the rippling of the still water as the ferry moved. It was moving smoothly on the water. There were rows of coconut trees on the bank of the river. You can see here is so many coconut trees. As we moved swiftly, I could see people fishing, washing, bathing along the banks and walking. Just before the sun disappeared into the water, the ferry reached the island and stopped. It was time for us to get off. At last, we reached Amma's place. What a long and interesting journey it has been. Now here are some questions we will solve after completing this chapter. Here are again questions. Now, a railway timetable gives details about the route of every train, the stations along the route, what time the train will reach and leave each station, the distance covered, etc. We can buy a railway timetable from a railway station. Some portions of the timetable for the route of the train on which Omana traveled are given. Look carefully at it and answer the following questions. You have to do yourself. Here are again some questions you have to do yourself. Now we will read chapter 9, Changing Families. Here are some pictures of families. These are the families of Nimi, Jering and Najli. Let us look at these pictures, talk about what we see and discuss. New arrival, heading of new arrival. There is great excitement in Nimi's family. She has a new baby sister. Look at the pictures and write. Who were the members of Nimmi's family before the arrival of her baby sister? How many, next question, how many members are there in Nimmi's family? Now, we will solve after completing this chapter. Here are again questions. Now, heading of new place. Jering's father received a letter from his office. The letter said that he was being promoted and would have to move to another city. When Jering's father showed the letter to his family, how do you think the different members would have felt? Here are some questions. What will change in Jering's family after his father's transfer? For example, who from Jering's family will live with his father at the new place? Which school will Jering go to now? Will he have new friends? You have to do yourself. Now, heading of it's a wedding. Wedding means marriage. There is great joy in Najli's home today. Her elder cousin brother is getting married. Now let's talk. Do you think that there will be any change in Najli's family after this wedding? What will change? Next question is, talk to your mother and aunts in the family. Ask them about where they lived before they got married. You have to do yourself. What did you see at the wedding that you attended? Draw some pictures in your notebook. Then look at the pictures drawn by your classmates. We saw changes taking place in the families of Nimmi, Jering's and Najli because of different regions. Here are some activities for you. Now, there are many girls who get married before they are 18 years old. Many of them have to even leave school also. There are many true stories of girls like Susila of Rangareddy district who are going back to school. She also got the help of the panchayat. The panchayat said that young children should play and study and not be married off. A group of people of Andhra Pradesh hold special camps to help married girls to go back to school. Jangamma and Chitti says, we would like to study and stand on our own feet. Here are some questions you have to do yourself. Now, your chapter is completed. Thank you, children.